people, welcome back to my channel. Salut les amis, bienvenue et bon retour sur ma chaîne. Hola, bienvenue dans la ami canal. Konnichiwa, watashi no chaneru ni yakusou. I hope you're doing fine today. This is another day, another week, and another video of me. We'll be talking about 5 main styling tips that would instantly, literally, transform your outfit for summer. Kind of show you what you gotta do with what you already have. Let's deep dive into it and just let's have a proper talk.
Whenever you are gone, I just wanna be with you. Please don't get.
If you haven't yet, definitely subscribe. I do a lot of fashion related videos. I'm a personal stylist, love to inspire people in general. That's my deeply biggest passion of them all. Fashion is something, and personal style is yourself, and whatever you're gonna make out of it. Just hit the bell button as well so that you can get notified every single time you're gonna have a video for you. I really specify summer because when it comes to winter or any cooler seasons, rules are different. Fall is always been my favorite season. I get to layer up. It gives such a great visual appeal. This is a really great way for you to play with the fabrics, to play with the textures, to play with the colors. I talked about it so many times in my previous videos, so definitely take a look into them. When it comes to summer, it's totally a different game. It's hot, you want to breathe, and you don't want to cover yourself as much. You want not to layer because you're gonna tie, but you want to play with another type of way of making anything stylish, go to your own personal style. Of course, I have a guide for it. It's gonna be down below. Definitely download it because it's full of exercises for you to be able to dig deeper onto what your personal style is. My first tip here when it comes to summer, makeup. You know that I'm not ultra big on having heavy makeup. I like to keep things really to a minimum, but I've had a phase when I enjoyed playing around with makeup, add a couple of colors just to make it fun, but the more I grew up, the more I just realize that I don't like it as much. Different because it's just my personality, doesn't mean that you don't have to do it. You want to keep yourself from like sweating too much and having your makeup melting because it's not pretty. Specifically if you live in a really hot area. In Montreal it can get really humid, but it's never a good idea here. Never ever ever. Instead of having to wear a foundation, BB cream. A lot of good things to themselves because they're much lighter on your skin and they're not as heavy as foundation can be. Anything too baked up, I would never really suggest it because it doesn't even make it modern for you. Focus on enhancing your natural glow when it comes to summer instead of having to put way too much cover on your face. If you have amazing eyes, really accentuate your eyes. If you have really nice lips, accentuate your lips. The second thing is to get your shoes either the full size or half size bigger than your feet. Because of the heat, your feet are gonna tend to swell a little bit, so they gonna be a little bit bigger. Water retention, they might not look as good on you, and you're gonna feel like maybe you grow a size bigger for summer. It's something that happens for most of us, myself included. And that's gonna lead me to my third tip, to mind your food breaks. In summer, you need to breathe. Like the heat, we like the sun, we like the brightness of it. I like that too. I just don't like the heat though. Actually enough, whenever I say that, people are surprised because I'm like literally from the tropics. So it should be hotter wherever I live, and I always say to people, not like that. Nope. Pick fabrics that are really easily breathable, and we're talking about the cotton, we're talking about linen, these favorite fabrics of them all. Silk is really good for summer as well because you can breathe with that as well. It's a different game when it comes to winter, where it's like the opposite of it, where you have to double or triple cover yourself. In summer you want to look pretty, but you want to look comfy because the heat is not gonna help you for that. I know linen has been big since last year, and Zara, you're gonna get a ton of pieces when it comes to it. The fourth tip of them all is, I hope you're gonna guess it, are you gonna guess it? Stay big on patterns. When it comes to colder seasons, I don't know. I think this is just that mindset because everything is gray, the sky is cloudy. It's never necessarily bright as summer is. Not inspired the same way. Play with the bolder, brighter patterns that you can handle, of course, and that you like. Of course, I'm not gonna tell you to go big bright on neon if that's not your thing here. probably gonna be a really good momentum for you to give it a try. Other patterns that you never really tried before, patterns are gonna bring such a good visual appeal. You can see here one of my favorite prints of floral, probably guessed it by that. Well, I hope so. I'm really playful with my colors. I love to keep them vibrant and try on some new colors, new patterns, new type of just combining colors and patterns all together. I'm sure for some of you it's probably the same thing. You evolve with your personal style. It's never static. It always evolves with you, evolve as a person, incorporate new trends and new style and new colors. My last tip here is to reinvent your clothes. A little bit similar to what I said, to try new colors and new patterns, work with them in another type of way. Long puffy skirt, get it tailored and to have a mini version of it. You can even take the leftovers for that skirt and use it as a scarf. Great hack for you to do, and that's just gonna give you another type of weight of wearing your stuff. If you have a long denim jacket, for example, you can crop it, you can cut it, and then you're gonna have a cropped version of it. Same thing's good with your old t-shirt that you know you're not sure what you want to do with them, and you can wear it with, let's say, a high-waisted jeans, pair of jeans, or high-waisted skirt, and have it with a blazer. I'm telling you, that's just gonna look amazing. Stuff you can do for summer when it comes to your own existing and current clothes, and for you to kind of revamp these clothes, give them a second chance. You know, it's like a relationship. Sometimes the guy or the girl can mess it up, and you just have to think it through, give it a time, and be like, give him another chance, or should I give her another chance? And sometimes just a matter of thinking here and be like, maybe it's gonna be worth it, or maybe it's not gonna be worth it. And some clothes are just not worth it. Sometimes you just are done with them, you pass that phase, and you just want to get rid of them. That was everything for my tips for summer. If you like that type of video, let me know what you usually do you when it comes to just changing your looks without having to do too much. Let me know that in the comment section down below. I have my guide on how to define your style even better, be even more confident within yourself. I'm gonna see you guys on my next video. Like I say all the time, smile because it's free and contagious. Bye.